NVIDIA SimNet is a GPU-accelerated simulation toolkit based on the physics-informed neural networks, or PINs. At Supercomputing 2019, we showed how SimNet could interactively explore the pressure drop and temperature variations in different heat sink designs to quickly converge on an optimal design. Today, we're going to look at how SimNet can help medical researchers simulate and predict the underlying blood flow physics in an aneurysm. While the blood flow in a vein or artery can be visualized using MRI and CT, determining the pressures and quantifying the flow is difficult. A brain aneurysm is ballooning in a blood vessel in the brain. If it ruptures, it can cause life-threatening bleeding into the brain. Selecting the right treatment option, which can range from removing the bulge to placing a stent or diverting the flow, depends on a wide variety of factors, but it often comes down to following the Hunt and Hess grading scale that was introduced in 1968 to classify the severity of the condition. The shape of the aneurysm and the blood vessel can be represented by a 3D CAD model. This enables patient-specific pressure and wall stresses to be calculated and taken into account in determining a course of treatment personalized to each patient's exact condition. With SimNet, doctors can get a far better estimation of the underlying flow physics in the blood vessel. Using time-based 4D CT and MRI imaging data to calculate the full spatial-temporal pulsating velocity field in the blood vessel allows doctors to quantify velocities, pressures, and wall shear stresses, something that can't be done with traditional imaging techniques. Unlike traditional CFD solvers, PINs have the ability to solve the data assimilation and inverse problems. SimNet can use imaging data to solve the Navier-Stokes and transport equations to model the flow field. Here we can see that the blood has an increased velocity due to the reduced diameter of the blood vessel. This, along with an abrupt change in direction due to obstruction, also introduces turbulence. Solving the fluid equations also provides data on blood flow pressure that's important in calculating wall shear stresses. This has a significant implication, as there's no way to directly measure flow pressure in the blood vessel of a patient in a non-invasive manner. The pressure color-coded flow streamlines clearly show the geometry-introduced recirculation in the aneurysm that gives rise to oscillatory forces on the walls of the blood vessel. The vasculature geometry and the pressure are then used to calculate the wall shear stresses, which are at the junction of the aneurysm and the blood vessel. This close-up view of the aneurysm clearly shows the pulsating, dynamic nature of the forces, which create cyclic loading that are eventually responsible for the fatigue failure of the blood vessel. The day isn't far off when AI can routinely provide a quantified report of the physiological variables that can help surgeons prevent a catastrophic medical event. SimNet is helping make this capability a reality.